have the time. Again, we know this will pass. It's just a question of when. So how do we hit the ground running in a proactive way? Your website, I mean, that's what it is. They call it the digital showroom. I say screw that. It's the showroom, period. And it was prior to this, right? Now it just is even more so. So take the time to fix it. So Melanie Borden is with us. She's the VP of marketing for Celebrity Motor Cars. And I know that she's taken some of these steps already. So she's working like crazy. I saw your post the other day. She said, I haven't worked this much and I can't remember when. So tell us what you've done for your dealers to work on some things like the website and things that Beth was talking about.
Sure. So just to give everyone some context, Celebrity is located in Northern New Jersey, and it's also located in Westchester, New York. So we have 6 points, 5 luxury brands that include Lexus, BMW, Mercedes-Benz, Alfa Romeo, and Maserati. So I have 3 principles that I think will help everyone that I've basically interweaved into our marketing. So number one, we are open for business. It sounds very basic, but it's something that if you don't have out there that you're open, I think generally the public might just assume that you're closed because dealerships, although services consider essential in some states, sales is not. So we're open for business and we're letting everyone know that we're open for business. In addition to letting them know that we're open for business, we're letting them know the ways that we can accommodate them. So we have pickup and delivery for service. We have the ability to do remote sales now that the governor just announced. We have the ability for our customers to purchase their vehicles online. So we have an 11-step process of sanitizing our vehicles within our loaner fleet and also the vehicles that are getting returned to home for service. So number two of the information, I would say, is a principle. So we're letting all of our customers know the information from the manufacturers that we're getting. Every single manufacturer has some sort of program that's running, whether it's 90 days no payments, it's 0% APR, whatever the case may be. A lot of them have different pull ahead programs. A lot of the programs are being announced as we speak. I'm getting messages and emails from the general managers at the stores letting me know what the programs are. So customers need to know, because although a lot of us that are out there might not necessarily be considered essential, but people still are buying cars, and we want to give them all the tools and all the information, all the facts that they need to be able to make the best decision. On the other side of that, we also want to give them information that's coming from the state regarding the dealership. For example, last week in our New York store, Governor Cuomo announced that he is making an amendment to ruling on dealerships being sales being essential. So we can now sell cars to customers with limitations in New York and now also in New Jersey. And we're letting all of our customers know that in our messaging as well. And I'll say the final piece of our marketing strategy that I've already heard today from everyone is empathy. So everyone here knows that Lexus is a luxury Japanese brand. And part of the Japanese culture, they have something that's called omotenashi, which is basically culture's version of hospitality. So in our messaging, in our stores, we want our customers to feel safe. We want them to feel comfortable. We want them to think that we are doing every single thing we possibly can to make them feel like they're a guest in our own home, just as we would as someone that would come into our own home. So that messaging has really been permeating through everything that we're doing. And we want to be sensitive too, also to the employees that are left working, that they're also not necessarily on the front lines in a hospital, but they're still dealing. Our service consultants, the techs and service department, they're also still putting themselves at risk with coronavirus. In addition to that, so it's just being sensitive to everyone and just trying to figure it out.
Yeah, I mean, like Michael said earlier, for those of you who maybe chimed in late, Michael Brown is with us, the owner of Empire Auto Group. He had to make the difficult decision to shut his Toyota store's service department down because 3 of his employees got sick. So, you know, exactly what you're saying, Melanie, is we have to also take into consideration the health and safety of our people, right, while still trying to keep the doors open so we can provide employment. So I think it's just it's something to keep in mind as well. It's not just empathy for the customer, right? It's empathy for the employee as well.
I also think that a lot of dealerships don't realize the resources that they have right in front of them that they might not be utilizing or maximizing. So, for example, Most manufacturers have a consultant that they have as part of the program. We all know them as Shift Digital. So Shift is connected to, let's say, 25, 30 brands. So this might not necessarily be someone that you would talk to on an everyday basis, but it's definitely a place that can help you with your website and your advertising messaging and social media that you might not necessarily thought to utilize in the past, because all the factory, now they're all saying, all right, we have to figure this out, and how are we gonna implement this and roll this out to all the stores? And this is one of the ways that they're doing it, is through Shift. So if you're not a your Shift person, you should be, for sure.
Great, right. And regardless of who your resource is, right? Because it differs from manufacturer, although Shift's the big one. There are those resources to reach out to, absolutely.